Congressional appearance this morning is the Honorable Jim Hagedorn, United States Representative with the 1st District of Minnesota.
Good morning, Chairman Johansson, members of the Commission. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for the opportunity. The testimony that we have today is about a constituent from my district and the very survival of an American industry. I happen to represent Minnesota's 1st District, and I wanted to thank you for the work that you're doing on behalf of American companies and workers who seek relief from unfair trade practices. I'd like to first associate myself with the remarks of Senator Klobuchar and Senator Smith. I believe they speak on behalf of the industry and behalf of the people of Minnesota. And I'd like to talk just a little bit more personally about our district and how this case affects the people of the 1st District of Minnesota. Our district spans from South Dakota to Wisconsin along the Iowa border. Agribusinesses coupled with innovative and entrepreneurial businesses and world-acclaimed healthcare from the Mayo Clinic all play important roles in our global economy and add to the quality of life of our constituents. This morning, I'm pleased to appear in support of one of the family-owned businesses in our district, Cambria Company, LLC of Le Sueur, Minnesota, and their 1,000 employees who seek relief from Chinese dumping of quartz surface products in our domestic market. During a recent conversation with the company's president, I learned how these unfair trading imports have impacted hardworking Americans. He explained how the Chinese imports have taken a greater share of the U.S. market, further eroding their business and resulting in reduction of good wage jobs, high wage jobs at their facility in my district. As he explained, the company was making a good deal of progress until 2015 when they discovered, imports at widely reduced prices than they were entering from China. Such a reduction in price is not feasible in this industry. As a result, from 2015 to 2018, Chinese imports totaled 21 million square feet and jumped to over 83 million square feet. After much careful thought and considering all the options available, the company decided to use the trade tools available and filed anti-dumping and countervailing duty cases in April of 2018 to help seek relief. Since that time, the Commerce Department has issued preliminary findings that resulted in countervailing duty rates in the range of 34 to 178%. And anti-dumping findings in the range of 242 to 341%. I support open and fair trade, and I also agree that trade is a two-way street in which we must ensure that our global trading partners are adhering to global trade rules. It certainly does not appear that Chinese quartz producers adhere to these rules. Rather, they choose to pursue channels that threaten U.S. companies and U.S. jobs. Cambria Company is another fine example of American business at its best. The company was founded in 2000 and began operations in 2001 and quickly established itself as a leader in the domestic production of quartz surface products. Today, Cambria Quartz is widely recognized in the design community, and I'm honored to have such an industry leader call Le Sueur, Minnesota home. I also wanted to emphasize that the company is not only a leader in the industry, but it's also a leader in our community. In addition to the employee enrichment programs at its facility, the company supports a wide range of community initiatives that support programs throughout the region and the counties of Le Sueur and Sibley in Minnesota specifically. During its 2 decades in business, the company has continued to make millions of dollars in investments that have benefited the local economy. Now, Cambria and its employees are great examples of what the country does best: American ingenuity, innovation, hard work, that result in quality products for consumers here and abroad. I would like to ask you that at this point you consider the case, give it a fair merit, and that you side on the side of the American workers and the company of Cambria. And for all the reasons I've laid out, I appreciate your time and considerations of this matter. Thank you.